The community of Gadette was chosen for two reasons. First, the unreliable water supply, which forces residents to store water in drums, and secondly, the resulting high-density mosquito infestation.
That is why we are also introducing what we call the ideal water container, where persons will be taught how to prepare that water container so that mosquito does not have very limited access to that container. It's a container where you have proper covering, and also you add a spigot to it, where the persons can access the water via the pipe.
The traps were designed by a company in Netherlands and do not use chemical insecticides, but are instead based on biocontrol agents.
It's a semi-lethal trap, because I say semi-lethal because it would target both the larvae and the adult mosquito, but it won't kill them instantly. It's a process. Inside the trap, we have a bacteria, two bioactives, a bacteria and a fungus. We also have a lure in the form of resist that would attract the mosquitoes to the trap. They would then come in the trap, lay their eggs, pick up the actives and spread it into other breeding sites around the house, around the households in a 400 square meter radius.
FDL said it was happy for the opportunity to partner with the ministry and to give back to the community. In handing over mosquito traps to residents, FDL and health officials underscored the need for them to be used in tandem with other measures to reduce mosquito breeding sites.
I don't think there's any magic bullet for Zika, but certainly the trap is one in the arsenal of weapons that could be used to attack the problem. We need a very integrated, intersectoral, multidisciplinary approach to this. Education is a big part of it. Various products, various technologies will help, but the basic thing is that persons need to take responsibility.
Not every household in the community received the trap. According to the FDL consultant, every house doesn't need one either. Because of the proximity of the houses, all residents within a 400-meter radius could effectively be covered by a single trap, music to the ears of residents.
It was a good thing. It was very good for the community. Even though people didn't turn out in a large number, but I hope it will help us to eradicate the mosquitoes and also the virus.
Health officials continue to underscore the importance of personal responsibility in eliminating mosquito breeding grounds and are encouraging all residents to regularly inspect their homes and communities for potential breeding sites. A similar exercise is planned for Mon Pinache. For the DBS News, I am Jenna Anne Gaston.